of the great aspects of this meeting is the international flavor, and we learned from all of our international colleagues who are here. So we've got been my pleasure to have Trevor Frayers from Brisbane, Australia join us. Trevor is a cardiac surgeon. Thanks very much for joining me.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
So tell me a little bit about the, you know, what's going on in Australia as far as this concept of a heart team.
Yep. It's something that's slowly taking seed and developing, and I think as you and I well know, with the whole onset of new technologies that and more difficult patients with more comorbidities, I think it's essential that we have team protocols in place to assess patients thoroughly. The workup has to be completed. We need discussions between not only cardiologists and surgeons, but incorporate anaesthetists and intensivists, particularly if these patients are going to undergo cardiac surgery, to assess them as well as we possibly can, work them up appropriately,
right.
And have a management strategy in place for those patients so that we can manage, you know, give them the best outcomes possible. And obviously in that process, we can then differentiate between who goes on for the percutaneous or other therapies that are available, which might suit them better. So I think the concept has been developed, in particularly in the United States, and I think that's the one good thing about, in my opinion, the slow growth of percutaneous and transapical valves. I think the beauty of it is that it's these patients are worked up appropriately and it's thought through very well by a team approach. And the major hospitals all run them, as you know. So we're lacking a little bit in that. We're hoping to set that up.
Well, I mean, it's an interesting concept of how you bring in, you know in your own practice and that you obviously interact with cardiologists. The cardiologist calls you up and says, I've got this guy with a bad valve, can you take a look at him? But I mean, I think you're right, as we get into more of the percutaneous therapies and for both aortics and mitral, and we get into more complex operative therapies, the concept of having sort of a dedicated team is really good. Do you think, is that something that will be rapidly embraced in your country?
Well, the big problem really is, particularly in the two-tier system, we have a so-called private system and a public system. The big problem in the private system, everybody's quite busy. But I think that's just an excuse. And the one private hospital I work in, you know, I will have a team approach running by the end of July, I've no doubt about it. And the cardiologists see the importance of it. And we've had, you know, operating on all the patients, the outcomes aren't always as we could predict. And
sure.
I think a more thorough workup and discussion, and I think more appropriate surgical strategies will then have better outcomes for patients.
And you know, and I think you're right, that's been really the offshoot, I think, of the whole TAVI and TAVR process in the United States, and now with the Mitra clip, is this concept of really people got to get together, discuss the cases.
Absolutely.
And it makes sense. Let me shift gears just very quickly. What's happening in sort of your practice, surgical practice in Australia? What do you see more of? What are you doing more of?
Well, I'm definitely doing less coronary work.
Right.
But I think it's also, I have a passion for mitral work, as you know, and gone to a lot of effort to educate myself and learn a lot of techniques and how to do mitral valve repair. And the benefits are there for me now. I also do them in a minimally invasive approach. And, you know, the outcomes, fortunately, so far are good. I have a dedicated database, so I can, looking at long-term outcomes and follow-ups as well. And I don't put the data in, I employ somebody to do it, because I think the minute you tamper with data, it's not what it should be. So from my perspective, I'm fortunate in the sense that I remain busy. I do a lot of valve work, particularly mitral valve work. You know, but mitral valve is challenging, as you know, and the larger volumes are necessary for good outcomes.
Oh, I think there's no doubt. And when you say you do minimal invasive approaches, are you using minimal sternotomies? Using
thoracotomy.
Thoracotomy.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm very strict about incision size. It really is small, and because I think you lose the whole objective of calling minimally invasive if you make a big thoracotomy incision. And so it's a slow learning curve, and I think, you know, I have no doubt you need to do about at least 100 patients before you become really comfortable doing them.
Absolutely. And, you know, this concept of a reference center is certainly something, the reference valve center really becomes important, because not only the team concept, but building up the experience, building up those numbers. So
absolutely.
That's a great.
I think, you know, once you establish a team concept, and it's known that if you have a patient with multiple issues and refer them to that unit, they'll get the workup, everything will be done complete, and the best therapy is worked out for the patient. I think it just creates work, and you know, you'll get more referrals.
Well, last question. You know, it's a small journey from Australia to New York. It's a long journey. What do you, because you're obviously an invited faculty, but what do you gain by coming to international meetings in other countries?
I think firstly the program, this meeting is excellent. I think the content is superb, and I think the most important thing for me is A, learning.
Right.
And I think the only way you see new concepts or learn how to do them is to see somebody present and then go and talk to them and ultimately maybe visit them. And not only that, you know, it also, you meet people and you form friendships and bonds.
Absolutely.
And if you ever have an issue with patient problems, you flick them an email, and the help you get from them is incredible.
That's fabulous. Well, I appreciate it. It's great for you to be here, and thank you for joining us.
My absolute pleasure. Thank you, Randy.